JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 16th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained versus the yen and franc, while it underperformed against the Aussie, the Kiwi, and the euro in that order. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the pound and the Canadian dollar. Now, the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi combined with the weakening of the safe havens yen and franc suggests that the markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that European indices traded a mix, but Wall Street rallied with all three of its main indices gaining more than 1%. Nasdaq even gained 2.15%. The optimism, albeit somewhat softer, rolled over into the Asian session today as well. Now, yesterday, the main event on the financial agenda was the FOMC decision. As was expected, the Fed dropped the transitory wording with regards to inflation from its statement and doubled the pace of its quantitative easing process, which means that conditional upon maintaining that pace for the months to come, the process will end in March. Most importantly, though, the new dot plot pointed to 3/4 point rate hikes in 2022 and 3 more for 2023, at a time when the financial community was fully pricing in only 2 liftoffs for next year. Now, in our view, the Fed was overly hawkish, even more than many market participants have been anticipating, at least according to the pricing of the Fed fund futures. After all, that's why the initial reaction at the time of the release was a stronger dollar and a small pullback in equities. That said, everything turned around very quickly, with the dollar coming under selling interest and stock indices rebounding strongly. Now, with no clear evidence as to why this happened, we can only assume that it may have been a position covering move, as the market as a whole was long dollars and short equities heading into the gathering. Perhaps some participants may have been expecting to lock profits after a potentially more hawkish Fed. Now, as for today, the central bank torch will be passed to the SNB, the Bank of England, and the ECB. The chorus starts with the SNB, the meetings of which have been passing unnoticed for several months now. However, things may be different this time around, as concerns how the new COVID-related restrictions can affect European growth have pushed Euro-franc lower near the 1.04 zone. With SNB officials maintaining the view that the franc remains highly valued, even when Euro-franc was at higher levels, we see decent chances for them to strengthen their wording about intervening in the FX market to prevent the pair from moving lower. Now, passing the ball to the Bank of England, we believe that all the attention will fall on interest rates. Following the outbreak of the new COVID variant and the new restrictions in the UK, market participants have pushed drastically back their expectations with regards to a rate hike at this gathering. The latest available data of the UK overnight index swaps suggest that a hike to 0.25% is more than fully priced in for March 2022. We don't believe that policymakers will surprise the financial community by hiking today, and therefore it will be interesting to see what they have to say for their future course of action. Hints that they could lift rates sooner than when the market pricing suggests could result in a rebound in the British pound. The opposite could be true in case they sound more hesitant. Now, a few minutes after the Bank of England, we have the ECB. No monetary policy action is expected by this bank, but it would be interesting to see what they are planning to do moving forward in the midst of fresh lockdowns, but also accelerating inflation in the euro area. Officials could announce that the pandemic emergency purchase program may be expanded for a while more, but even if they signal that it will still end in March, we believe that they will be willing to compensate through other schemes like the APP, the asset purchase program. Something like that, combined with more warnings that interest rates are unlikely to start rising anytime soon, could result in another round of selling in the euro. Now, as for the rest of today's events, besides those three decisions, we also get the preliminary manufacturing and services PMIs from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, as well as the US industrial production for November. As for tonight, during the Asian session Friday, we have another central bank deciding on interest rates, and this is the Bank of Japan. With Japanese inflation near zero, well below the bank's target of 2%, we don't expect any material changes, neither to the actual policy measures nor to the language accompanying in the accompanying statement. Once again, the yen may not react to the outcome and stay driven by developments surrounding the broader market sentiment. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.